Hey guys. So, as a graduate student in School of Social Work, this is a topic that I've recently come across a lot, and it's been discussed a lot around me, especially in the classes that I'm in. And it's a discussion about psychology and social work, you know, the career path between the two. The two fields are completely different. Where it'll take you is completely different, but there's so many commonalities that exist between the two fields that I feel like it's an interesting topic to talk about. I think it's a topic that will take me multiple videos because I feel like there's so much to talk about here. The first thing, I guess, I want to start this discussion talking about kind of a conversation I had with a colleague of mine. So the program I'm currently in is a two-year program. So there are many different kinds of programs to get your master's in social work. I personally should have been on to the advanced standing or the one-year program because that program is only for people with bachelor's in social work, which I have. But I didn't qualify for that, so I'm in a two-year program. And two-year program is, you know, open to anyone with a bachelor's. So you can have a bachelor's in engineering, and you could probably get in. I don't know how difficult that would be compared to someone with a bachelor's in social work, but I think it's certainly possible. But because of that, almost like a lot of the people I meet who are, you know, taking this course with me, a lot of them have bachelor's in psychology. And they come. In my internship, the other intern, there's an intern from Long Island University, and she's on her second year of her school of social work, pursuing a master's in social work. And she's a psych mate. She had a bachelor's or BA in psychology. So the two are very, very similar, especially in regards to mental health. And that issue, you know, you want to work in the mental health field. The two degrees, I mean, it's going to end up very different where you're going to end up, even in mental health field. But the two degrees have a lot of commonalities. Anyway, the first thing I want to start off is with the conversation I had. So one of the guys in my class, and we were in the policy class, you know, after policy class, it was the stuff we were discussing in the policy class was really intriguing. We hung out with the professor a little bit after class, and then we're like, oh, we should talk some more. And we went to a bar, and we started like talking about a whole bunch of different things. And one of the topics we ended up talking about was stigma and demonization of the field. So I feel that social work is a field that not many people know about, and many people even have really negative views about. And simply because the way media has portrayed, or the way people know social work, you know, if people know about social work at all, it's because they think social workers are going to take their babies away and put them in foster care or something like that, which is what social workers do because of the foster care system is the way it is. But, I mean, that's generally where I think social workers are known for. So there is kind of this demonization of social workers. I mean, in any field that social workers are in, they are kind of, it's an underappreciated field. And, you know, a lot of people say it's a thankless job. A lot of people say that about education, like teachers, it's a thankless job, but they do it because they're passionate about teaching and raising their kids. I think a lot of the social workers feel the same way. They go into this field knowing we're not going to make much money. If you want to make money, this is not the field to go into. And a lot of social workers who go into the field, they know that going in, although a lot of them got burnt out because the reality can be crushing even though you want it in. Anyway, we're talking about that a bit, which is interesting for social work, that the fact that not a lot of people are aware of it, and it's demonized so much, because social workers are everywhere, especially in a state like New York City. Social work is everywhere. Social workers are in prisons, in schools, in corporations. There is corporate social work. They make tons of money, by the way. I think that's probably the social workers that make the most money, people who go into the corporate field. But there's corporate social work, there's schools, various nonprofits, you know, homelessness, finding jobs for people who are poor, working with the government, all that. All that kind of social work. Social workers are everywhere. And hospitals, too. Actually, hospital social workers are great. And private practice. A lot of therapists are social workers. A lot of your therapists are social workers. And that's where the commonality is with psychology, because half of therapists have been shown to be social work majors, and half of them have psychology majors. So what's the difference there? That's probably going to be talked about in like the future videos. But I wanted to, the thing that we talked about was like, well, my friend was, or my colleague was just like, I just think like psychology is something that's so stigmatized and demonized, you know, going into this field. And I was like, what? Okay, I always felt that social work, you know, that's my bias, was like the demonized field, because not a lot of people are aware. And when people are aware of us, they see us as baby takers, you know? And he's like, yeah, well, there's that point. But, you know, when people go looking, you know, when people seek psychology services, there's a stigma on that, you know? It's like, oh, that guy's, the minute you say, you know, I'm seeing a psychologist, it's like, oh, what's wrong with you? Like, are you okay? Are you crazy? You know, so in that sense, I think there is a stigma in seeing a psychologist. And I guess because psychology is more towards the medical profession, you know, if you take, there is various tracks in psychology as well. You can go into the field of psychiatry, in which case you get a doctorate in psychiatry or whatever, and you have to do residency just like doctors and just like, you know, just like doctors. Yeah. So it's a medical profession, but doctors and surgeons and such don't look at psychologists the same way. So I think in that field, they're definitely kind of looked down upon in a way. So that's an interesting thing to think about. There is definitely stigma in seeing a psychologist versus seeing a social worker who is there to get you the right benefits. Like a social worker who's there to make sure that you are linked to Medicare, Medicaid, and food stamps, there's really not that much of a stigma on that. You know, if you are seeing that kind of a social worker. My colleague makes a point, because social work is so lesser known, like most people are not aware of the social workers they come to meet, or social work as a profession. Because we're so less aware, there is less of a like kind of societal stigma against it. What is stigmatic though is something like, well, when I was pursuing my bachelor's degree in social work, I used to intern at a place called Housing Works, which is the largest organization in the country that does this, that provides services to people with living with HIV and AIDS, and those same people needing assistance with housing. Largest organization in the country. So it's well known in New York City as well. So sometimes I do the home visit with clients. You know, clients hasn't been coming in for 2 weeks. I want to know what's up with the client, you know, so I go to their homes. And sometimes I go into the apartment and, you know, there's like the security guard who's protecting the apartment, whatever. I can't tell him where I'm from. Because the minute I say I'm from Housing Works and I'm going to see this person, the minute I say that, there's a possibility that this worker, the security person in the building, will be aware that that client has HIV. Because that's what the agency is. And HIV and AIDS thing, it's something that a client, you know, wants to keep it a secret from everyone else. There's an issue of confidentiality here. So I can't do that. You know, I have to be, you know, I'm a friend of this client, so I'm here to visit him. Or, you know, I work at a nonprofit, and I'm his caseworker. Something like that. Because there's such stigma with people who have HIV and AIDS still, even in New York City, and of course, much more so in other parts of the country and other parts of the world. So especially since, because large portion of our population, the HIV and AIDS population that we serve, are the LGBT community. A lot of transgender people, gay people, lesbian people, or other people who don't necessarily fit the straight category or the heterosexual category. So yeah, a lot of those people are who we serve. As workers in Housing Works. So there's definitely a lot of the people that social workers serve have things, there are things about them that are really stigmatized, you know, poor people, especially recently. There's so much stigma on poverty, so much stigma on homelessness, So I feel like the clients that we serve, that social workers serve, are definitely, there's a lot of stigma going in them. And I feel like same could be said for people who, you know, visit psychiatrists and psychologists and such. So that's definitely kind of a commonality there. But it's kind of interesting where the stigma is. I think with psychology, there's stigma in just seeing the psychologist. And with social work, there's stigma with, you know, just because of who they are. Just because of the fact that they're homeless, there's stigma. Just because of the fact that they have HIV, just because of the fact that they're gay, there's a stigma on that. So it's interesting how, you know, the clients that both professions serve and where is the stigma, where is the demonization. I can't even say that word right now, but you know what I'm getting at. That's been the topic of this video. But yeah, I will continue talking more about comparing the two professions, because I think it's a really interesting topic. And also, a lot of people are aware, psychology is a more established field than social work in society. When I applied to School of Social Work, I didn't even know what social work was. Well, before I applied, when I started applying to colleges, didn't know what it was. It was a college that told me what it was, so I ended up applying. But yeah, it's a very interesting topic, I think. If you guys have any comments or questions on this, feel free to let me know. I admit, I do have a more social work bias here. So if you are a psych major, yeah, share your comments. I'm always, you know, I really respect the psychology field. It's not my field, but I respect it. You know, my closest friend has a master's in psych, so we always have a very lively discussion because our perspectives are so different, even though our fields are so similar. But yeah, take care.